Good evening, RedHawks fans. My name is Natalie Valvo, your host for today's Miami University's men basketball game against the Jackson State Tigers. The RedHawks are currently 2-4 overall, playing against some tough competition in their past few games. They faced off against Indiana University on the 20th, where fifth-year guard Larry Mackay scored 12 points and freshman guard Billy Smith had a total of 8 points. Their most previous game was against Little Rock, where the RedHawks got the dub of 80-67. Again, Larry Mackay was the leading scorer with 25 points. Right behind him was Billy Smith with 18 points, and freshman Ryan Mabry had 12 points, and senior Anderson Maribel had 12 points as well. Marimbo is a transfer student from Cleveland State, and he is a force to be reckoned with, standing at 6'8 and 305 pounds. This men's basketball team is a good mix of upper and lower class players under the new reign of coach Travis Steele. They are looking to do a lot better this season than they have in previous ones as they adjust to some new coaching transitions and new player transitions as well. But from what I've seen from warmups here at Millett Hall, it seems like this team has meshed pretty well. Seems like the teamwork that is there is good. They're giving each other high fives, making their three-pointers. It's going to be a good game today against Jackson State. About Jackson State, head coach Mo Williams enters his first season with the Tigers as well. Coach Williams played 2 seasons at the University of Alabama and had a 14-year career in the NBA. He actually got a championship with the Cleveland Cavaliers in 2015 and 2016, which is really impressive. Coach Williams most recently served as the head coach at Alabama State University. And guard Keller, and it's a pleasure to have him here playing for the RedHawks. You wouldn't want another guard for your team like we got for him. He's amazing. So Larry now has 1,294 career points. He is in his 17th place on the program's all-time list after passing Bob Brown on Saturday. Against Georgia, Larry also surpassed his college career high points in points, 34, and produced the first 30-point game for RedHawks since March 9, 2020. One of the most efficient free throw shooters in this conference, Larry ranked first in the MAC in free throw percentage in the 21-22 season. His free throw percentage ranks first on Miami's single season list, and his career free throw percentage also ranks first. Larry hit 29 consecutive free throws from November 27th through January 29th. He was perfect from the free throw line in 18 of the 25 games where he attempted a free throw shot. Mackay has started the 22-23 season 28-30 from the free throw line. You know, free throws are an easy bucket to get, and you need to be consistent at it, and Larry's obviously got that secured. It's just like a nice field goal in football, what a free throw is. In fact, a free throw is a little bit less of a risk than a field goal because it's just you on that court. Yes, you've got three people on either side of you, but as a skilled player like Larry is, you know, you just focus on the ball and the basket, and that's all that matters in that time. You make it, and then you get right back on defense. So two RedHawks had double-doubles in Miami's first win versus Geshan College. Sophomore transfer Julian Lewis made his season debut, tying his career high of 17 points and setting a new career high of 10 rebounds. Again, freshman Billy Smith recorded 11 points, 12 rebounds, 6 steals, and 4 assists. This year, the RedHawks boast 5 freshmen, 3 sophomores, 3 juniors, 3 seniors, and a fifth-year senior. In the second game against Geshan College, Miami forced 27 turnovers. This is the most for a RedHawk opponent since November 17, 2015. Miami recorded 18 steals, second highest in program history, led by freshman Billy Smith with 6 total. Miami fans, you need to be on the lookout for this Billy Smith. He's going to be tearing it up on this Miami court here, not only this season, but in his years to come. We've got a nice little turnout here on this Tuesday evening. It's 6:45 p.m., and we've got both sides of the stadium filled up here a little bit. We've got the band over to the left of me, and we've got Jackson State warming up as Miami just headed back into their locker room. Julian Lewis, who is a guard from William & Mary, where he averaged 7.2 points, 4.3 rebounds, and 2.3 assists. He recorded a career high of 17 points versus Delaware and a career high of 8 assists against Valparaiso. As a freshman, Lewis was named to the CAA All-Rookie Team. This season, Lewis has averaged 12 points, 6.5 rebounds, and 3.3 assists. Morgan Safford, who was a guard from Wolford College, during his tenure, he averaged 7.7 points, 3.8 rebounds, and 1.2 assists. He recorded a career high of 21 points versus Coastal Carolina as a redshirt freshman. During his first campaign, Safford was named to the 2020-2021 Southern Conference All-Freshman Team. This season, Safford has averaged 10.5 points, 3 assists, and 5 rebounds. Anderson Marimbeau is a center forward from Cleveland State University, like I said earlier. While attending, he averaged 1.5 points, 1.7 rebounds, and 0.7 assists with the Vikings. Prior to Cleveland State, Marimbeau attended Trinity Valley Community College. At TVCC, he averaged 13.4 points, 8.3 rebounds, and 1.1 assists. In his first game with the RedHawks, he set a career high of 27 points. Up to this point, he is second in points scored for the RedHawks, averaging 13.7 per game, and he has also averaged 4.2 rebounds and 1.2 assists. Got to keep a lookout for these RedHawks. They're going to be tearing it up today. There's a lot of talent on this team, and they're just really starting to peek through with it all. We'll be right back from Millett Hall. This is Natalie Valvo. We are back here at Millett Hall. It is 6:51 p.m. and we are about 10 minutes away from tip-off-ish. So Miami is the winningest program in MAC history. Has won 21 league titles and made 26 postseason appearances. The RedHawks' last NCAA tournament appearance was, though, in 2007. With Travis Steele as the 28th men's basketball head coach in program history, after coming from a four-year stint at rival Xavier University, where he posted a 70-50 mark while coaching the Musketeers to two postseason berths, he is looking to bring an exceptional recruiting pedigree and results here at Miami to help them keep that legacy of the most winning of being the winningest program. In addition to recruiting two nationally ranked classes among the top 20 as head coach, each of his student athletes graduated during his time at Xavier. As an assistant at Xavier University, he also helped secure two top 10 nationally ranked recruiting classes, made four NCAA tournament appearances, twice advancing to the Sweet 16, and won a conference championship. And that's what we are looking for here at Miami University, is for Coach Steele to do the same for our Fighting RedHawks. Steele has coached at the high school, AAU, junior college, and Division I levels. He's held nearly every role on a staff, from volunteer to grad assistant to assistant coach to video coordinator to director of operations to head coach. He was hired as a director of basketball operations at Xavier in 2008 before being elevated to assistant coach, associate head coach, and then ultimately head coach. Well, the RedHawks are just coming back out here after coming from the locker room, and we've got a great game ahead of you, RedHawk fans, and I will be sending it over to play-by-play Patrick and Color Jack. Over to you guys.
Thank you very much, Natalie. It is the Miami RedHawks. It is the Jackson State Tigers on the floor at Millett Hall here this evening. Patrick Getch and Jack Schmelzinger are with you. RedHawks 2-4 overall. They have not yet played a MAC game. Jackson State 0-5 overall, still looking for their first win of the season. The Tigers have played all five games so far on the road this year. It's just the sixth of nine straight on the road to start the year for the Tigers this season. And so, Jack, the RedHawks coming off a 13-point win over Little Rock on Saturday, a pretty good home showing for Miami, and it's about building on that momentum here tonight at home again on Tuesday.
Yeah, Patrick, it really was a good game for these RedHawks back on Monday, and a really good offensive game for them. They really have struggled a lot on offense so far this year, especially just hitting their shots, but RedHawks started out really hot in the first half. Billy Smith, six threes in that first half, and after that, they started to cover Billy Smith a little more, and Makai Larry took the reins, ended up with 25 points himself, so a really impressive offensive performance from the RedHawks. Head coach Travis Steele in his press conference this week really stressed the fundamental side of the basketball, and that's where Miami really thrived back in that game against Arkansas Little Rock. We'll see if they can do it again here.
That's true. Meanwhile, you got a Jackson State team with a first-year head coach as well. Mo Williams is leading their squad. He's got a long history in the NBA. We can talk about that later on in the game. But a Jackson State team, you imagine you start nine straight on the road. It's got to be so tough. And the travel schedule, too. They were at Michigan on Wednesday. They were at Indiana on Friday. Tonight they are at Miami. And although it's not that much travel in terms of mileage, you're out of your home for that much time. You're away from your friends. You're away from your classes. You're away from everything. It's got to be mentally tough for a Jackson State team that has yet to play at home this season.
Absolutely. And, Patrick, they've been pretty up and down. Obviously, you mentioned they are 0-5, but that's not too surprising when you play nine straight home games to start the year. They actually had a really good showing against Michigan, only lost 78-68 in that game, but then the next, or a couple nights later against Indiana, they really got drubbed 90-51. So it's been an up and down start for these Jackson State Tigers. It'll be interesting to see which team shows up here tonight.
Apologize, Miami legend Mike Wolf came on the air there for a little bit. Didn't realize we were on the air. But yeah, you're right, a Jackson State team that just trying to figure it out this season, that's for sure. We'll see what they can piece together on the puzzle so far tonight. And a Red Hawk team that is coming off, of course, that 30-point loss to Indiana before that on November 20th. It seems, though, that Travis Steele's team kind of piecing it together a little bit by a little bit each game this year. That's good to see.
Yeah, Patrick, and just listening to the press conference, listening to a couple of his players talk, Makai Larry and Billy Smith were featured in that press conference this week. It really seems like these players are bought in. They really trust Travis Steele, his game plan, and it seems like it's really going to come down to them making shots. They really want to make hard cuts Travis Steele said the ball has to move. They want to play deep into the shot clock, and they did that well against Arkansas Little Rock, the best that they've done all season.
Right.
Really, it comes down to making shots once you get that working.
That's true. All right, let's do it in the public address, our national anthem and starting lineups. Great job, as always, by the RedHawk Pep Baneers. We'll get our starting lineups announced inside the arena momentarily. We'll carry that for you live in front of a pretty light Tuesday night crowd here inside Millett Hall this evening. Typical Miami basketball crowd.
Yeah, Patrick, and just one interesting little tidbit that a RedHawk fan, Dick Close, not sure if he's listening, but brought to my attention. This Miami team so far this year is actually second in the entire nation out of all over 300 Division I college basketball teams in free throw percentage. So,
really?
Yep, if they are able to get to the line, you know that the RedHawks are going to sink those shots.
That's pretty cool. Jackson State starting lineup is being announced right now. I hope you don't jinx that tonight, though. You never know.
You're really, yeah. I would feel bad. Hopefully no one who's listening right now would rat me out to the Miami basketball team.
All right, so the Jackson State starters are Zeke Cook, followed by Chase Adams, Romel Manziel, Ken Evans Jr., and Colty Young for Jackson State. And the RedHawks starters announced momentarily. Let's listen in. So there we are, your RedHawk starters tonight. Makai Larry, Julian Lewis, Billy Smith, Morgan Safford, and Anderson Marombo. That'll be the starting five for the RedHawks tonight. Jackson State is in road dark blue uniforms. Jackson across the front in red with a red number on the front and a red number on the back. The RedHawks will be in their home white uniforms tonight with red number on the back. And then Miami across the front in red with a red number, as well as the Millett Hawk crowd stands to their feet awaiting the first Red Hawk points of the night in front of Miami and Jackson State. Little homestand going on for the Red Hawks. This is the second of four games. Of course, the Little Rock game last Saturday. This is game two tonight. Saturday against Indiana State. Red Hawks are home at 1 o'clock, and then they will host a game on Sunday, December 11th against the Calumet College of St. Joseph in Indiana. Red Hawks move right to left across your radio here in the first half of play. The opening tip-off will be taken by Anderson Marambo for the Red Hawks, 6'8 senior from the Dominican Republic. Romel Manziel, the junior from LA, will take the tip for Jackson State. He stands at 6'9" for the Tigers.
Patrick, nothing better than watching the big man jump. Anderson Mirambo listed at 305 pounds. I'm not sure if I believe it. He looks even a little bigger than that, but going to be fun to see him try and outjump the 6'9" Manziel.
Manziel's got him by an inch. So you got to wait for the ESPN Plus signal to begin the game. Referees are holding on for that as the crowd here is riled up for this one tonight. Red Hawk women played last night. They beat Loyola Chicago on this floor. Red Hawk basketball team's trying to make it a 2-0 start to the week. Four-game home week for the Miami basketball teams. Our referees tonight are Edwin Young, Todd Von Sassen, and Alfred Smith. So here we go. We'll get to see this tip. Marambo and Manziel as they get them set up there at half court. Referee throws it in the air. The tip is won by Jackson State. Easy win by Manziel. The game is on from Millett, and it is the Tigers with the basketball to start. Over the timeline, middle of the floor is Chase Adams. Fed to the near wing, a give and go with Ken Evans Jr. Back to Adams, top of the key. Near wing outside the arc with the ball is Manziel. Near corner, he took an extra step and traveled, and the Red Hawks get it on a turnover here, 18 seconds in.
Patrick, good to see Morgan Safford back in the lineup. He came back from an injury last game against Little Rock, and he had a really good game. 9 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists, and Safford, one of the captains, one of the biggest leaders on this team, a real guy who keeps the culture up on this Red Hawk team.
For real. Very positive guy. Billy Smith with the top of the key, far side Safford, the Wofford transfer with it to the far side of the paint where the ball is Marambo. He will go with a left-handed layup. It's in for two from near the MAC logo with the left arm, and the Red Hawks draw first blood up 2-0. A little under 45 seconds into the first half of the game. Zeke Cook with a ball for Jackson State. Near wing outside the arc, feeds to Ken Evans Jr., cuts across the paint, left wing shot from the side of the paint, missed it too hard, rebound. Zeke Cook fought for it for Jackson State, but he was upended there by Smith. Relax, working up the near wing of the floor, and from the corner, a drive there from Julian Lewis is in for two. Right arm floater that makes it 4-0 Red Hawks. Good transition move by Miami. Top of the key, Jackson State. Colty Young's got the ball. Back up top for Zeke Cook. Left wing outside the arc will dribble between his legs. Shovel a pass left side of the paint. With it there is Manziel, and a foul is whistled. He's trying to feed it back down low in the paint through to Cook. Red Hawks going to get the first foul of the game. And Safford's going to pick it up for his first with 18:39 to go in a first quarter. Miami leads 4-0, a first half, I should say. Far side inbound, Jackson State from their own end. Quick bounce pass from Evans Jr. into Manziel, who puts it off the window for two. Tigers find the board to make it 4-2. Larry's over the timeline, right wing for the Red Hawks. Hands it top of the key for Billy Smith. Bounces on the right elbow. Marambo holds it above his head. Far side, Safford, right wing three is good for the Red Hawks. First triple of the game belongs to Safford, 7-2 the score. Adams with the ball, top of the key. Shovels far away to Colty Young. Back up top, Adams. Jackson State on offense. Near wing, they float a pass to the right side of the paint. Cook with it, working underneath. The right-handed shot hung on the rim. It fell off, no good. Offensive rebound, they work it far side, and Young will drive a three hole for Jackson State. Colty Young shooting 27% from outside the arc this season. No points against Indiana back on Friday. And he's got three here tonight. Larry takes over the timeline, left wing for the Red Hawks. And he is fouled by Adams in a 7-5 game led by the Red Hawks with 17:48 to go in the first.
Patrick, you can already kind of see this Jackson State team trying to speed Miami up on offense. going over into their backcourt and kind of pressing them as they bring the ball up the floor. Travis Steele said this week that he really wants to keep have this team move slow on the offensive end. Jackson State trying to counteract that.
Yeah. Our side with it is Lewis. Gets it up top of the key for Larry. Bounces to the left elbow. The jumper there is good. Job by Larry from the left elbow with a nice jumper. Athletic move. The jumpers, he's dangerous. Left wing a three by Colton Young. Quick try for Jackson State. Too much on it. Top of the key, Manziel to the far side for Chase Adams. Left wing outside the arc. 12 to shoot for the Tigers. Goes far side. Another three try. Young is good. And Colton Young feeling good over there on the far side outside the arc. It's a 9-8 Red Hawk lead. Smith puts it inside for Larry. Back to Billy Smith. Red Hawks will take it over the timeline. Larry with it on the right wing. Less than 3 minutes in, 9-8 Red Hawk lead. Left side of the paint goes a feed to Marombo. Hands it off Larry, top of the key. Bobbled it, got it back. Right wing, he'll drive it around the arc. Adams providing a lot of pressure. Now Lewis back up top of the key, Marombo. Left wing outside the arc, Safford with a screen and a three, and it's good from Safford. He's made a couple triples in the game, and it's 12-8 Miami. Manziel with it, top of the key, Jackson State. Smith working on him in the paint. He'll float one to the near wing, outside the arc, Cook back up top of the key for Adams. He's going to drop a play here with some arm movement. 10 on the shot clock. And back here to Evans Jr. Far wing outside the arc is Chase Adams with it. Get a hand up high from Larry Adams with three to shoot. Macklow with the paint, floats it back. The shot is good. Jumper there, he found some open room in the paint and got it to go. 12-10 Red Hawks from 7 feet away. Larry's over the timeline, left wing, hands it up top to keep for Lewis. Red Hawks return to the offensive end of the floor. Right side of the elbow with it is Marombo. Feeds left wing, here's a three try. Lewis gets it in. These triples raining for the Red Hawks, who are 3 for 3 from outside the arc so far in the game, and it's 15-10. Miami on top. Adams goes top to keep for Evans Jr. Far side, it is a three try that's good for him. Jackson State's Chase Adams. It's just a 3-point contest so far. Millett 15-13 Miami. We're not even 5 minutes in yet.
Pretty fun to watch.
Oh yeah. Smith top of the key at the half court area. Gives it up for Marombo. Standing with 1 foot inside the arc, left wing. Marombo bounces down low, Safford up and under, too hard off the window. The follow-up coming through with Smith to finish with the right arm off the window, 17-13 Miami.
What a no-look pass from Marombo there, finds Morgan Safford cutting back door.
Third side with a Chase Adams, really good play on the other end. Right-handed dribble, he'll take it top of the key, 15 to shoot Jackson State. Left wing, he'll drive a three home. Evans Jr. puts it in, and a timeout is called by the Tigers as Mo Williams, their first-year head coach, decides to whistle his first timeout of the game here. Just try to kill some momentum, maybe in a 17-16 lead for the Red Hawks, 14:54 to go in the first.
This has been a pretty fun game to watch so far. I mean, Miami shooting 100% from three on three tries so far, 87.5% from the field, and Jackson State not doing much worse. Pretty fun to watch. Both of these teams have so much success on offense early, you have to figure it's probably not going to last, but.
Right. We'll see what happens. Red Hawks lead by one to get immediate timeout. 14:54 to go in the first. Back in a moment. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. 17-16. The Red Hawk lead, 14-54 to go on the first half. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with the inside Millett Hall this evening. It is a triple contest right now inside this building.
Really fast start on offense from both of these teams, and Jackson State playing at a really frantic pace. Miami, I think it would be good for them to kind of slow them down a little bit. Jackson State just moving around the court so fast, and a couple times Miami just has gotten a little bit lost on defense, not able to get some rebounds they probably should have gotten. Probably an easy adjustment to make, though, going forward.
Yeah. Frantic pace to this game, probably why Mo Williams called a timeout for the Tigers to send us to the media break. Right to the basketball and offense out of the timeout. Near wing with it outside the arc, Ryan Mabry. Far side with it. On the right wing is Safford. Feeds to Mabry up high on the left side. Top of the key, Marombo. Will work with eight to shoot. Left side of the paint. Gets his way down low with a bounce pass behind the back to Safford. And the layup is good. Beautiful stuff from Marombo. You can't make it up. He fed it behind the back from the left side of the paint, and Safford came through with beautiful timing down the middle to finish off the window for two. And Jackson Stain on the other end will go up for a foul, and the shot does not go in for the and one. Jamarcus Jones there with a good strong attempt on the right side of the paint with a layup. Marombo gets the foul for his first. RedHawks second as a team, 14-10 to go in the first. Jones to the line for two, and a 19-16 RedHawk lead.
Patrick, just going back to that behind-the-back pass from Marombo, maybe one of the best plays that I've seen in my years watching Miami basketball, and who wouldn't want a 300-pound point guard on their team?
Doing beautiful stuff like that, too. First one by Jones was no good. Marombo's going to come out for a moment.
And you can really see why Coach Travis Steele made Anderson Marombo one of his captains for this year. That pass was just such high basketball IQ, incredible floor vision there from Anderson Marombo. Really? He really thinks the game, you can tell.
And Safford, the great finish too, with the timing coming down. So both free throws missed at the line there for Jackson State and Jamarcus Jones. Relax with the ball on offense, they lead by three. Far side to Yumbo with his Morris. Hands it off outside the arc in the right wing as Safford up top of the key. It was fended by Mabry, got tipped around. Red Hawks stay with it. Morris feeds right wing with eight to shoot. Top of the key with it. Mabry feed to the near corner. Here's a three try. Billy Smith sinks it. 22-16 Miami, 13 and a half to go in the first. Billy buckets the chant from the two-man student section behind us. Near wing is Adams, outside the arc in the near wing with 15 to shoot. Far side with it in the corner is Gabe Watson. Left side outside the arc is Evans Jr. Here's Adams driving left elbow with a pull up on Larry. Too much, a little bit too far right as well. It crashes out of bounds. RedHawks tipped the rebound out the baseline and a stay with Jackson State. They'll get a 20-second shot clock with 13:15 to go in the first, and a couple new faces are gonna come in for the Tigers on the whistle. Lewis going to come back in for the RedHawks. Looks like Manziel returns from Jackson State alongside Keevion Hunt, who will make his first appearance. Inbound comes near side of the Jackson State offensive baseline. Evans Jr., a float pass to the outside of the arc. It goes back to him on the near wing. He's going to shoot a three ball too far left. Rebound pops out the baseline, and it will stay with the RedHawks here as an attempt by Jones to chase it down for the Tigers didn't quite work out. And Miami inbounds to our right on their own baseline here with 13:09 to go in the first. RedHawks lead by six. Smith inbounds far side to Ryan Mabry. Over the timeline here on the right wing, Mabry with a left-handed dribble on the big red M at half court. Dribbles it down low and feeds to the free throw line for Morris. Morris left elbow outside the arc. Three try Mabry, too much. Rebound Jackson State. Manziel works for it. Feeds up ahead, transition. Here's Hunt. Will feed it to the near corner. Three try. Colty Young too far left. Rebound, they crash for it. RedHawks end up with a basketball as Morris brought it down for Miami. Here's Larry. Feeds on the timeline left wing. Lewis back up top. Larry wide open. Three for the top of the key. Missed it left. Rebound tipped around, Manziel ends up for Jackson State. Feeds Evans Jr. over the timeline here on the right wing. Right-handed drill to the near corner. Colty Young feeds right side of the paint. Working there is a drive to the hoop and off the window for two with the right arm. Jamarcus Jones with a nice drive up the baseline for the near wing. And it's 22-18 Miami. Over the timeline, right wing for the RedHawks. Billy Smith with a left-handed dribble, top of the key. Feeds it on the far side for Larry. Top of the key with it here is Smith to the corner. Three try Mabry, yes sir. 25-18, the RedHawks are 5-for-7 from three-point land.
And they're getting everybody going from three here today.
Strength in numbers. Jackson State up high on the left side. Hunt feeds to the far corner. Give and go with Evans Jr. Back for Hunt. Drilled down the left wing. He traveled. And that'll do it for immediate timeout here inside Millett Hall with 11:43 to go in the first. RedHawks 25, Jackson State 18. An offensive showdown here for Millett tonight. And this is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. .43 to go in half number one. Miami 25, Jackson State 18. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you inside Millett Hall here on this Tuesday night from Oxford. Jack, it's an offensive showdown so far. This team played pretty well in the early going for the RedHawks.
They are, Patrick, and Travis Steele has really emphasized so far this year playing fundamental offensive basketball, just trusting your game plan and letting the open shots come and just riding the open shot, not riding one player, but just whoever's open, let them shoot the ball. And that's been working well for the RedHawks so far. They haven't really had a main scoring option. Just everyone's getting in the fun. And it's really been fun to watch here so far. And, I mean, 25 points through less than 10 minutes, that's pretty impressive.
Right. And 18 on the other side for Jackson State. You've had about 53 combined points between the two teams already tonight. Not even at the halfway mark of the opening half yet. Running to the ball, the timeout on offense. Lewis with it, top of the key, feeds to the near wing for Will Stevens, who's in the game for Miami now. Back up top, Jaquel Morris. Far side with it is Mabry. He gets fouled. Never mind, they're going to say it's an offensive violation away from the ball by the RedHawks. As Morris made contact away from the play. So Miami's third as a team in the first half, and Jackson State will get this one back on offense as Kevion Hunt takes it over the timeline here on the left wing. Dribbles with the right arm, being guarded up top by Lewis. Far side with it is Mabry, outside the arc. It's Manziel now, left side of the paint. Looks spin around and put it off the window for two with a nice athletic move through traffic with the right arm. And it's 25-20 Miami. Hunt's over the timeline here on the right wing. Lewis hands up top the key for Safford. Near wing outside the arc is to Well, Morris back up top. Safford, three ball too far right from the top of the key. Offensive board, Miami. Lewis near way in the corner trying to drive baseline. It popped out of bounds. Will stay with the RedHawks as a Jackson State hand knocked it out. Miami will inbound near side of their offensive baseline with 17 to shoot. 10:50 left in the opening half. Miami 25-20 leaders over Jackson State.
Patrick, you mentioned Will Stevens a couple games ago against Marshall Stevens. After the game, Travis Steele was really singing his praises, saying you could really feel him in that game. He's a really hard worker, the walk-on senior.
Yeah. Top of the key with it is Mabry. To the near wing outside the arc, Julian Lewis. Back up top here for Morris. Far corner, three ball is good. That was Mabry who sunk it. 28-20, the RedHawks 6-for-9 for three-point land tonight. Hunt with it over the timeline here on the left wing. Hands it off for Manziel. Top of the key for Jackson State. Back in the hands of Hunt. Walks it up high on the left side. 10:20 to go in the first half. Hunt drives down the middle. Get tipped away there by Morris on a shot block. First side it goes. Here's Laro, the timeline on the right wing. Far corner. Mabry the three. A whistle blew the play then. There was too much on it. The shot never went in. Is this a foul on the Redhawks? I believe it is on Larry.
Really nice block on the other end from Jaquel Morris there, and he led the Brooklyn area high schools back in his senior year last year with 2.1 blocks per game. Pretty impressive stuff from the freshman. He also had 16 rebounds per game in that league, so you can count on Morris to get those blocks and rebounds for you.
That's a lot of rebounds.
Yeah, and that's the type of player that all good teams have, especially in college basketball.
Yep. So Cook will inbound here for Jackson State in their own end of the floor. Adams with it over the timeline here on the half-court line with a right-handed dribble to the near wing outside the arc is Young. Right side of the paint working here is Manziel. He'll fall back for a jumper. That's good. Redhawk defense going to collapse there near the post. 28-22 Miami with 9:48 to go in the first. Mabry's over the timeline on the right wing for the Redhawks with a left-handed dribble. Up top, the key with it. Bounce pass to the near side outside the arc. Marambo in an unfamiliar spot up high. Feeds the right wing outside the arc. Lewis at the free throw line. A bounce pass left side of the post. And Mabry goes up with the right arm to finish for two. And it's 30-22 Miami. Chase Adams over the timeline, middle of the floor for Jackson State. Goes to the far wing, feeds to the far corner. Manziel's on it here with a right-handed dribble, working up against Safford, left side of the paint. Top of the key now, Adams. Shovels a feed to the far side outside the arc. Young now down near the baseline, far wing. That was Manziel to the right side of the post. A feed through the air and a great finish by Cook. Although the basket going to be waved off here for an offensive violation. It's Cook drove in and created an offensive foul. Knocked over a Red Hawk defender. It's going to go back to Miami. 9 minutes to go in the first half. 30-22 Redhawks. Larry's over the timeline here on the right wing with the ball. Left-handed dribble goes top of the key for Marambo. Back for Larry on the right side outside the arc. 15 to shoot for the Redhawks. Far corner. Three ball. Lewis pops in and out. Rebound crashing in there was Jones for Jackson State. Now near side outside the arc is Adams with the ball. We'll throw one up top of the key. That was a jumper for two that was missed short. Rebound tipped around in the post area. Heads out of bounds. Off the hand of Zeke Cook of Jackson State. And the Redhawks going to get it back here on their own baseline far side with 8:32 to go in the first. Something's going on with the university president. Keeps jumping out of his seat and walking around.
Yeah, and he was on his phone earlier. He seems a little distressed. I can't really tell. Maybe he's just really... really amped up for this Miami basketball game.
He always is.
Yeah. The field hockey, though, that might be his favorite sport. He loves those games.
Mabry top the key for Smith. Redhawks on offense here. High on the right side, Larry, to the near wing outside the arc. Mabry. Right side, Larry's outside the arc with a right-handed dribble. Far side, Safford. Near corner, they go for a three. Mabry, too much on it. Rebound fought for Smith. Hands it back, Jackson State with a rebound here. They'll pick it up, take it over the timeline to the far wing. That's Ken Evans Jr. Evans Jr., left side of the elbow, feeds to the near corner. With the ball here is Manziel, drives his way baseline, feeds right wing to Cook, who will float it off the glass. He was trying to go for a little two-handed shot there and was fouled from in near the hoop. And we'll see who gets it for the Redhawks. Larry was in the area, so is Safford. Might be one of those two. It's on Mabry, actually, who is also there, and it'll be his first of the night. Media timeout, 7:50 left in the first half. Redhawks hold on to an 8-point lead, 30-22 over Jackson State. Miami basketball on Redhawk Radio. 30-22, Miami over Jackson State with 7:50 left in half number one here from inside Millett Hall tonight. This Tuesday night crowd pretty riled up so far for the RedHawks, leading by 8.
Yeah, they really are, and we've got a couple real RedHawk faithful right behind us in the student section cracking us up a little bit.
Yeah.
And good to see the Miami fans coming out in pretty good strength here on a Tuesday night.
Yep.
And where else would you rather be, honestly? I mean, this has got to be the best thing going on campus right now.
Definitely, within a 20-mile radius.
Right, honestly.
That's true. So you get Cook at the line here for Jackson State. He's going to shoot two. Under the timeout, 20% free throw shooter this season. And the first one is too hard. They're saying, we want Deion.
Deion Sanders.
Chuck Martin is sitting three rows away.
Basking in the Bahama Bowl glory and pretending not to hear them.
Next one is missed by Cook. They're just saying Deion Sanders is going to go to UC, but we'll see about that one.
Do they say that? Interesting. That would be interesting.
Cincinnati people talking.
Right.
Avery outside the arc for the RedHawks. Near wing is Billy Smith. Top of the key with a right-handed dribble inside Marambo. Left side of the elbow. He got a feed to the corner. It was picked off by Cook. Jackson State back up the floor. Adams over the timeline on the right wing. Will hit the brakes. Walk his way back top of the key. And the Tigers here set up on the offensive end. Top of the key. Cook will drive his way around the arc left wing. Then go to the hoop on a baseline drive. He floated up and shot. And hit the rim short with the left arm. And dropped back to the RedHawks in the rebound. And here's Mabry with it up high on the right side on the offensive end for the RedHawks. Larry up high on the left side now. Goes top of the key with the ball. Shovels a pass near wing. Safford. Give and go in the corner with Mabry. Top of the key, Smith. Safford left wing. Open three look. Too far right. Marambo swats the rebound out top of the key. Here's Mabry. Near corner now. Safford to the rack. And he's called, or a blocking foul rather, called on Jackson State as falling over was Colton Young. On a good drive to the rack by Safford. The shot went over the rim with the right arm. And we'll have two free throws at the line, I believe, for Safford coming up. 6:49 to go in the first.
RedHawks doing a really nice job moving the ball around, and they're not settling for anything but a great shot here early in this game. It almost seems like they're moving it a little bit too much. Maybe sometimes you could settle for those little less than great shots. But
first one is good. So a RedHawk lead of 31-22 at the moment. Cook comes out for Jackson State. Coming in is Jamarcus Jones. Next one from Safford is good. So Ken Evans Jr. to Chase Adams over the timeline here on the right wing for the Tigers. On the right-handed dribble. Boats it down low to Manziel at the right side of the paint. He could not get the pass. Was contacted there too hard by Marambo. And that's going to be a foul on him, his second. Team foul number six on the RedHawks with 6:42 to go on the first. You're going to have the inbound come near side of the baseline for Jackson State in the offensive end. Ken Evans Jr. will send it away. He will float this one up high on the right side. Colton Young with the ball. Feeds to the near wing outside the arc with it. It's Ken Evans Jr. to the rack. He got blocked down there and a good shut down by Lewis. Put back one over the hoop. And they still with a rebound are the Tigers. Evans Jr. hands out top of the key for Manziel. Up on the left side is Evans Jr. with a basketball, right-handed dribble, sidestep three. Too much on it with two to shoot, tipped out of bounds. And the RedHawks will get it as it was tipped out by Chase Adams in his right arm for Jackson State. You have 6:19 to go in this first half of the game. 10-point RedHawk lead. Larry's over the timeline with it here on the right wing. Up top of the key, Billy Smith for the RedHawks. Larry far side on the outside the arc area. We'll pivot around to the right foot. Top the key, Safford to the near wing. Outside the arc is Lewis. Julian Lewis, the right-handed dribble to the left side of the elbow. Here's Safford. Goes far wing with it for Billy Smith. Top the key with it, Larry. Far side, Smith. Far corner, Safford. Three ball with one to shoot. It was too much. Rebound, Jackson State with a basketball. It's Adams on the timeline here on the right wing. Floats it far side outside the arc for Evans Jr. Left side of the paint working here is Jamarcus Jones. We get a whistle for a foul before he tried to get a shot off. It's going to be on Miami. And Morris is going to pick it up for his third. The RedHawks seventh. Morris going to come out. and be replaced by Mitchell Riley, the freshman from Fort Mitchell, Kentucky.
Patrick Riley replacing Mitchell, who was really Miami's main defensive player on the floor at the time. So going to get to see how the freshman does guarding, presumably, the 6'9" Romel Manso.
Yeah.
Who the Redhawks have done a pretty good job guarding so far, even though they don't really have anyone as big as him.
Right.
Kind of playing defense by committee on the big Jackson State forward.
First one from Jones, and a 1-1 too hard. They're going to call a violation, though, on Jackson State. Going to go back to the Redhawks. It's a good point. Riley's made three appearances this season. Last time he came out was at Indiana, where he played just 2 minutes in that game. So a good chance here for the freshman to see what he could prove. Here's Larry up high on the right side of the far side for Safford. Up top the key with it is Redhawks with the ball. Julian Lewis now left wing. Three try. Larry's good. Nothing but net. 5:20 left in the first. Miami 35, Jackson State 22. Adams with the ball on the timeline on the right wing. Top of the key, Manziel. Hands it off for Colt Young. Jones with the top of the key. Hands off Adams. Swooping around for the near side. Down low right side of the paint. Where it went to Jones. It hopped off his foot. The officials saying out. And the Rocks will get it as the ball lost there at the baseline by Jackson State with 5:06 to go in the opening half. Inbound will come from Billy Smith to the near wing where Lewis has it for Miami over the timeline on the left wing. Right-handed dribble for Larry, top the key. Far side, Smith with the ball, back up top. Lewis shovels it right elbow with the feet of the far corner. Three ball, Smith, too much. Rebound, Jackson State. Evans Jr. is with it over the timeline here on the right wing. Evans Jr. bounces down low with an up and under dunk there with Manziel going behind him to put it up and into the rim for two. When you're 6'9", you can do that stuff. 35-24.
Must be nice.
Just kind of jumped up and a little backwards dunk. Far side, Smith with it, top of the key, Larry. Down low to the left side of the elbow for Safford. Outside the arc, Lewis. Give and go feed with Riley to the corner. Safford, the feet out of his reach. A little bit in front of him, went out of bounds, and the Redhawks turn it over on that with 4:20 left in the first half.
Just a little bit of a sloppy pass there from Julian Lewis, and you'd hope that the Redhawks here with 4 minutes left in this half don't take their foot off the gas pedal.
Adams to the far wing for Colt Young. Goes to the far corner with it here, Jamarcus Jones. Back up high on the left side is Manziel outside the arc. Right-handed drill to the near wing for Young, who's just going to call a timeout. And head coach Mo Williams is furious at something right now. Livid. So it turns into a media timeout, and we will take a quick break. 4:04 to go in the first half on a Jackson State timeout. 35-24 Miami with the lead. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. 4:04 to go in the first half, 35-24. Miami leaders over the Tigers from Jackson State. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger with you here from inside Millett Hall. Or it's a steady lead so far throughout the first half of the RedHawks, and Mo Williams here was furious going the last time out. The second one he's caught from Jackson State. Tiger team that has competed in this game, but they've never found what it's going to take to beat Miami so far tonight, I don't think.
Yeah, and they've seemed just a little bit discombobulated. Yeah. It kind of makes sense considering that this is their sixth straight, game on the road. Just really playing pretty fast, not able to kind of just play a cohesive game so far.
Right. Far side, outside the arc. Young will try a triple. He missed it short, but the rebound follow-up. Evans Jr. came right to the rack to tip it in for two. It's a good job there. 35-26 with 3:43 to go in the first. Top of the key, Larry to the near wing with the basketball is Safford. He'll feed it to the far wing, Mabry. Back up top, Safford, top of the key, right-handed dribble. Far side, Mabry to the far corner, Larry. Will try to feed it through the middle, get tipped off the hand of Evans Jr., who's up ahead for a breakaway for Adams, and he will travel. He had a breakaway up the right side of the post. He tried to flip it in for two. He had Larry chasing him down pretty hard, and traveling on the play was Adams. A step too many at the last second before he threw the ball up.
And that won't make Mo Williams feel any better.
He doesn't like anything right now.
You got to feel bad for him, too. First year head coach, 0-5 to start.
And you got nine straight on the road when you look at the schedule.
Seriously.
Near side with it, Safford for the Red Hawks. Bounces top of the key, Riley with the ball down the right side of the paint. And he will put it off the window too much. Jackson State with a rebound wide open with Manziel to get it. And over the timeline on the right wing is Evans Jr. And this is going to go back in the way for a violation on the Tigers. Foul called to number 13, Romel Manziel, inside the paint. And nothing going right for the Tigers right now.
And Mo Williams just standing there on the sideline with his hands on his hips, looking like my dad used to look at me when I would do something bad. It's like, seriously? Seriously?
I'm not mad, I'm frustrated. And we got a technical call against Williams. At least, did they call a technical on him, or? I don't know who got the technical.
I don't either.
Yeah, it's not like Williams was causing, maybe he was saying some quiet stuff to the referees.
Yeah, that's what it would have had to been, because he was not animated at all over there.
No, he was just frozen. First one from Larry's good. He's going to shoot two free throws here by himself at the line.
Williams kind of interesting. The hometown boys from Jackson, Mississippi.
Yes.
Won that 2016 NBA championship with the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Yep. Next one, goodbye, Larry. He had a long NBA career, lasted over a decade, played for Cleveland, Milwaukee, the LA Clippers, Charlotte, Minnesota, and Portland. It's quite a tour.
And I wonder, I guess it's just the Jackson State thing now to hire former successful pro athletes as your head coach.
Inbound here, top of the key with the basketball is Makai Larry for the Red Hawks around the arc. Top of the key with it is Safford here. We'll hit the brakes. Bounce pass to Lewis. Near wing outside the arc is Larry. Left side of the elbow with it, Lewis. Bounces out top of the key. Larry's got the ball with 10 to shoot, and he will bounce it down low. Up and under move by Safford. Doing the right arm for two in the post. Coming from far side to near side to finish.
I'm starting to see why Williams got that technical. For the first 20 minutes of that shot clock, you did not stop talking in the ref's ear.
Far side three is too short from Colty Young for Jackson State. Offensive rebound, though, for the Tigers. Left side of the paint, they try to feed it outside the arc. Young to Jones, didn't quite work. Larry picked it off with transition, near wing three, Lewis, too far left. And the rebound to Colty Young for the Tigers. Adams with it over the timeline here on the left wing for Jackson State. Top of the key, Manziel. Work it to the near side of the post, up and under move, off the window. Too much Evans Jr. had on that. Rebound to the Red Hawks, and here's Larry over the timeline, middle of the floor for Miami. 1:45 to go in the first, 39-26, the Red Hawks lead it. Lewis, top of the key with the ball is Riley for the Red Hawks. Near wing outside the arc here, Mabry. Right-handed dribble, right side of the paint area, trying to flip up a shot. It was too hard to get a foul here on the rebound. It's going to go the other way as Riley went over at the end of the play. The fans don't like it.
Zeke Cook is
refs are getting a lot of their negative feedback right now.
Yeah, they're really earning their pay here tonight, just getting no breaks from anyone in the crowd on the floor.
So Riley gets his first personal on the play. It's going to set up some free throws here with the eighth team foul against Miami for a bonus. Jamarcus Jones will fire the first one off, and that's good in a one-and-one situation.
Patrick, this student section is really small, but you got to think they probably getting at least a little bit in these Jackson State players' heads out there. I mean,
sure.
they're so loud, you can sure hear them out on the floor, and they're just saying the stupidest stuff that I wouldn't be able to focus, honestly.
Next one from Jones is good. 39-28. I couldn't make a free throw either with them barking like that.
Screaming about Deion Sanders.
Smith over the timeline here on the left wing and the big red M at half court for the RedHawks. Goes to the far corner on a feed. Here's Mabry. Miami leads by 11. Top of the key with it, Safford. Mabry, right wing three with a screen. It's good. Nothing but net defended there by Jones. 42-28, Miami on top with 105 to go in the first half.
Saw Billy Smith have a real breakout game last time. This might be Ryan Mabry's turn, the two freshmen.
That's true. Adams over the timeline, middle of the floor. Hands to the near wing for Evans Jr. Top of the key with it, Zeke Cook. Right-handed dribble around the arc. Feeds to the near wing. Evans Jr.'s on it here for Jackson State. Floats it down low, leaping up for it. Jones, he caught the pass, then was fouled by Safford coming back down. Foul number two on Safford in the night tonight. 49.4 to go in the first half. And a 42-28 Red Hawk lead. Cook is going to come out for Jackson State. One and one free throws here. Jones ready to shoot at the line. Football rejects.
They're good. They're small, but they're good.
Jones will flip the free throw in. 42-29, the Red Hawk lead. Red Hawks bring out Safford.
Miami Athletics needs to get these kids on their payroll.
For real. They're going to pay him $500 for showing up.
Right, that's
lucky.
True.
That's why they're here, maybe. Jones, the next one, good. And the 12-point lead now for the Red Hawks, 49.4 to go in the opening half. Larry's with it over the timeline, middle of the floor for the Red Hawks to the right-handed dribble up top the key. Near wing, outside the arc, Mabry, three ball. Good for the Red Hawks. Timeout called by Mo Williams. No, it's a timeout by Travis Steele. I beg your pardon. Miami calls the timeout with 38.6 to go in the first, 45-30. The Red Hawks 9 for 19 from outside the arc. That's 47.4%. They are shooting 55% from the field with 45 points so far in this first half.
And what a beautiful shot there from Ryan Mabry. That brings him up to 4 for 7 from 3 in the game, 5 for 9, 14 points. And you love to see the way he shot that ball, just absolutely no hesitation throwing that thing up. And great to see that type of confidence from the freshman, especially after a few rough games to start it off. But, you know, Travis Steele likes to say these guys got to sink or swim, and they've sunk a little bit so far to start this season. It seems like Ryan Mabry at least is starting to swim a little bit, at least tread water.
Yep. For sure, especially tonight, 38.6 to go in this first half, 45-30. Red Hawks win the lead as Travis Steele uses his first timeout of the night there. Mo Williams, by the way, was the head coach at Alabama State 2 years before this. So it's not like he's new to this whole head coaching thing. He has experience in the league, too, the Southwest Athletic Conference. Top the key with the basketball is Adams for Jackson State. Works to the far wing outside the arc. Evans Jr. gets to the left elbow, and the basket will not count as he shot it too hard. Foul on the Red Hawks. Under the hoop, Stevens got it.
And Patrick Stevens, last game, I started to say this earlier, but Travis Steele after the game said, you know, Will's not the most talented player. He said that's no slight on Will, but you could really feel him out there. Will Stevens was only in that game for 9 minutes, but he committed the 5 fouls necessary to foul out. He actually committed 2 before the ball was even inbounded the first time after he got out there. So Will Stevens out there making his mark.
First one from Cook is good. At the line for Jackson State, and Stevens goes right back out of the game.
I think that was like 2 seconds?
Yeah.
played 9 minutes against Little Rock, didn't score any points, like you said. Cook, second free throw good. Shot clock is off, 20 seconds to go in the first half, 45-32, Miami with a lead. Here's Larry over the timeline on the right wing with a right-handed dribble on the big red M here at half court. Larry just holding on, 8 seconds to go. Shovels a feed to the near corner. Marambo working, spinning around, left side of the paint. Kicks it out far corner, Smith. Now far side, Larry, a three ball, buzzer, too hard, and a little bit right. And that'll do it for the opening 20 minutes here tonight from Millett Hall in Oxford. The Miami RedHawks take the halftime lead to the break of 45-32. All cylinders cranking for the RedHawks in that opening 20 minutes, coupled with Jackson State, could never find a break either.
Yeah, RedHawks playing really nice, really well on the offensive side of the ball, over 50% from the floor, over 45% from three. When you do that, you have a good chance for success, and they're playing pretty well on the defensive side of the ball as well, getting out-rebounded pretty heavily. That's the one thing Miami really needs to clean it up a little bit on the boards. It seems like they're just not really in position much, especially on the defensive glass, so a little bit to work on at halftime, but pretty good overall so far for the RedHawks.
Yep. I would say so. 13-point advantage at the half. Can they continue with doing the second? That is the big question. Time now for the halftime report. We send it over to Natalie Valvo. Natalie.
Thank you, Patrick. So great first half by the RedHawks here. They're up 45, and Jackson State is at 35. And oh my gosh, can Marimbo play some basketball? He is so skillful and tasteful with his IQ. He's slick with his passes, dropping dimes left and right. It was about mid-first half down in the key, RedHawks ball. And he did a nice little behind-the-back pass for the perfect layup. Unfortunately, the layup was missed, but then Billy Smith was right there to put it right back in. In this game, you have Billy Smith has had 5 points, and he's gone 2-3 from his field goals and 1-2 from the 3 points. He's had 1 rebound, 2 assists, and has played a total of 14 minutes. Larry has played 7 points, has made 7 points. He's gone 2-4 from the field goal, 1-3 from the 3 point, and he's 100% from the free throw line going 2-2, keeping his free throw record going strong. My God, can this guy shoot free throws? Can he be consistent with it? Well, one thing I'd like to see, you know, Larry is more on the smaller side. Something I would like to see, though, and, you know, it is a little bit difficult in a sport like this just because of his height, but I would like to see him draw a little bit more of that contact and see him go to the free throw line some more times. I mean, this free throw percentage should be like a 4-for-4 type of thing. But because of his height, he can use that to his advantage to really drive that shoulder down low, bringing it to the rack and drawing the 2 free throw. We've got a halftime show going on here. I think it's funny. I know the student, our little small student section over here was being talked about, and they're going crazy for the two kids going against each other in this halftime show. But back to the game, Safford had 12 points, going 4-for-8 from the field goal, 2-for-5 from the 3-point, and as well 2-for-2 from the free throw. He has 1 assist, 1 steal, and has played a total of 18 minutes. Lewis, it has 5 points, going 2-for-4 from the field goal, 1-for-3 from the 3-point, 2 rebounds, 1 assist, and 1 steal. Marimbo has 2 points, 1-for-1 from field goal, 3 rebounds, and 4 assists. That's a lot, you know, for the big guy like him. He's looking at potentially getting 8 assists this whole game. He's played a total of 10 minutes only, so to get 4 assists in those 10 minutes is pretty impressive. Mabry has 14 points, going 5-for-9 from the field goal, 4-for-7 from the 3-point. He hasn't drawn any foul shots yet, but he has 1 assist, played a total of 12 minutes. You know, this freshman guard is really stepping out of his shell in tonight's game. Last game it was Billy Smith, this time it's Mabry. So it's going to be exciting to see what he can hit in the second half coming up here. Over for Jackson State, kind of a slow start. Coach Williams not really seeing what he wants to see. With that being said, Zeke Cook has 2 points, going 0-for-3 from the field goal. No 3-pointers and 2-for-4 from the free throw, 3 points, excuse me, 3 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 steal, and 1 block. Romel Mansell has 8 points, going 4 for 4 from the field goal. It's really impressive. 4 rebounds, 1 assist, and 1 steal. Right behind him, and that is going to be Colty Young. He has 6 points, going 2 for 6 from the field goal and 2 for 5 from the 3-point. You know, this has been a pretty high 3-point shooting game. Like Mabry over here is 4 for 7, but having 14 points, so you just got to keep shooting those 3 balls and they'll start dropping. Of course, when you fall in that slump though, you just go ahead, do a little pump fake and dribble it right in, right? Just a half inch into the key there, and you got that nice little, or on the wing, and you got that nice little jump shot there, and you know, those shots will fall, and once those shots get falling, then you step back out into the three. But this has been a pretty quick paced basketball game. Coach Steele's got to be happy with how this team is doing. Just playing smart and just connecting on all ends of the court, using their athleticism and their speed and their height, their ability here against this Jackson State team. You know, it's really important. You know, they came out in this first half with a pep in their step, and it's going to be really telling how they enter the second half. You know, that first 3 minutes is going to kind of really determine the game. I know the score is 45-32, but in college ball like this, the game's not over until that last whistle is blown. So if Jackson State comes out with a little bit more energy and Miami's caught flat-footed, this game could change for the worse. But if Miami comes out guns blazing again, they should be looking good. It'll be an interesting game to see what happens here. So with that being said, I'm going to send you on over to commercial, and we'll be back. This is Natalie Valvo with Red Hawk Radio from Millett Hall. Thank you.
45-32 the score as we start the second half here from Millett Hall in Oxford, Ohio. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger are with you from this fairly loud arena tonight. And Jack, for the RedHawks in the second half, kind of like Natalie talked about at halftime, just going to be about finding that groove, continuing that groove, just continuing the energy and the poise they showed in that first half of play.
Yeah, Patrick, and this is almost the exact same score we saw a couple of games ago. Miami Marshall is 45-31 at halftime. Miami was down. Marshall ended up chasing 100 in that game. So, personally, I would love to see Miami get up around there. Be interesting to see if their offense is able to carry that explosiveness and that real just consistent and efficient shooting
right
through into this second half.
We'll see what happens. The RedHawks will open up the second half with a basketball. It will be thrown in by Julian Lewis from near side of the baseline to Makai Larry. And the second half underway from Millett Hall. He's over the timeline, middle of the floor with a right-handed dribble. Bounces over on the far side for Billy Smith. Top of the key with it. Feeds Marambo, right side of the elbow. The RedHawks offensive end as Miami moves left to right across your radio here in the second half. Marambo feeds top of the key with the basketball as Smith gets left side of the elbow. Feeds far corner. Larry back out left wing. Smith wide open. Three. Yes, sir. 48-32. RedHawks 30 seconds into the second half. Billy Buckets. It's one for two for 3-point land tonight. Jackson State with the ball here on the near wing. Here's Manziel with a jumper. It was too hard there from 10 feet away. Rebound RedHawks. Marambo to Larry and on to the left wing for Safford. He'll hit the brakes near the RedHawk bench outside the arc of the offensive end. Feed Marambo left side of the paint with a basketball. He flipped a behind the back pass to Safford over his head. And Safford on the right side of the post with a finish for two.
Ridiculous stuff from Marambo. He's that made three beautiful passes tonight. It's crazy. Sports Center type passes.
Seriously. Evans Jr., left side of the paint, Manziel, jumper there, in and out, rebound pops down. We get a foul whistle here. As Marambo is on it with Cook as they battled for the rebound. 50-32, Red Hawk lead with 18:43 to go in the second. Inbound will come on the baseline here, near wing for Jackson State. These students are getting real restless here behind us. They're waiting to see who gets the $500 checks for coming tonight. Near corner, Evans Jr. wide open. Three on the inbound. He was airball over the hoop. Here comes Larry with a basketball out of the corner on the far wing. Over the timeline, Larry drives right side of the post, hits the break, spins around, left-handed shot. The floater is good from Makai. Great athleticism there. 20-point Red Hawk lead with 18:22 to go in the second.
A little sneer from Makai Larry after that one. He's feeling himself.
He is.
And he should be.
Near wing Evans Jr. outside the arc. Drives baseline. Kicks it out. Jones left side of the paint with a basketball to the right side. He will float up a shot. And there's a foul. It tipped out of bounds. And Morris will get his next personal for the RedHawks. That is his fourth foul of the game already for Jaquel Morris. Freshman out of Floral Park, New York, so free throws at the line here on the shooting foul for Jamarcus Jones. And the senior will bounce a couple times before the first one. Flip it up and good from the line. Jones has appeared in all five games off the bench this season, including this one tonight.
He's already been to the line three separate times.
Yep. 4 for 6 from the stripe this evening with 6 points. Next one will come through here for Jones. It is too hard. Rebound fought for, tipped to the baseline. It will go out of bounds and score with the RedHawks. Yeah, Lewis there picked it up, tried to fling it off the Jackson State player who was on the floor. Manziel, it went off him and out of bounds. Kind of a purposeful play there. The RedHawks inbound on their own baseline. Smith will send it in.
And pretty nice from Julian Lewis there. He threw that ball off of number 13 for Jackson State. That's Romel Manziel, but then he helped him up immediately. You could tell he felt a little bad.
Smith will toss it in here for Mabry over the timeline on the right wing for the RedHawks. Outside the arc, flips it top to Kiefer Smith. New wing Mabry on the right wing with 16 to shoot. A little over 2 minutes into the second half. Top of the key, Safford flips it far corner. Three ball off Smith. And it's good. It bounced off the rim, up in the air, and went through. Billy Smith makes it 55-33. They chant USA. Top of the key with it is Evans Jr. for Jackson State. Goes down to the free throw line. The jumper there pops it out from Colty Young. Rebound in the hands of Cook, and they tie him up. It was Safford in there who did a lot of that. And the jump ball whistle call here. Jackson State will have the possession in their favor at the moment. Get it back with 20 to shoot. 17-25 is left in the second half. 55-33 Miami. Coming out is Mabry. Coming in for the RedHawks, Mitchell Riley. On the baseline, Cook for Jackson State. Floats it out top of the key. Evans Jr. brings it down. Goes to the far side for Colty Young. Back up top of the key, Evans Jr. Left side of the paint, Jones. Floats it right side of the post. And a nice dunk made there by Romel Manziel. And the junior from L.A. makes it 55-35. And Hawks lead it. Manziel to start in every game so far this season, leading Jackson State with 10 points tonight. First player in double figures for them. Top of the key is Riley. Hands back Safford. Far side Lewis. Left wing outside the arc. Top of the key now back for Safford with 10 to shoot. Inside of the paint area for Riley. Flips it out off top of the key. Lewis around the arc. Gets it down low. Larry to the left wing. Three ball Safford. He stepped out of bounds. Trying to jump up and shoot it. And they're going to call the RedHawks there. It's going to go back to Jackson State with 16:42 to go in the second with an inbound near the RedHawk bench on the far wing. 55-35, the Red Hawk lead over Jackson State. Flipped in middle of the floor for Evans Jr. over the timeline here, middle of the floor for the Tigers. Right-handed dribble, feeds far side for Young. Top of the key with it, Cook to the near wing now, Evans Jr. with a basketball for the Tigers. Inside the paint, Manziel, right side of the post, to feed there to Jones off the window for two with the right arm, and it's 55-37 Miami. Here's Larry over the timeline, left wing for the RedHawks. The right-handed dribble feeds up top the key for Safford. Back up on the left wing outside the arc, Julian Lewis with the ball. Flips it off to Billy Smith up top the key. And he will wait, get it to the near corner. Three ball is in and out. That came from Mabry near corner. Jackson State, the rebound. Evans Jr. over the timeline here on the left wing. Left-handed dribble, he'll feed it to the left side of the paint. Jamarcus Jones is on it, off the glass, and in for two with the right arm. Good shot there by Jones. And the RedHawks get the ball back here as Jackson State, 55-39, they trail. Larry's over the timeline with a basketball, middle of the floor. Dribbles between his legs, drives left side, hits the brakes at the left elbow, back outside the arc in the left wing. Goes back up top to key for Ryan Mabry. Here's Safford with it, holds on with both arms, 10 on the shot clock. Safford, the red carpet rolled out up the right side of the post, but they blow the play dead for a foul on Jackson State. Evans Jr. is going to pick it up for the Tigers, and that'll be his first of the night. 15:23 to go, we get immediate timeout in the second half. 55-39, RedHawks lead it over Jackson State. This is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. 55-39, the Red Hawk lead over Jackson State. As we have 15-23 to go in the second half of the game. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you inside Millett Hall tonight. The Red Hawks team that continues to push so far in the second half, or at least early on. As the Red Hawks tonight still shooting 57% from the field, 47.8% from three-point land. They are 4-for-4 from the line. Jackson State 41% for the field, 40% from three-point land tonight, 58.3% from the free throw area. As our media timeout wraps up here from inside Millett Hall. Early on in the second half of this game, Red Hawks trying to make it two wins in a row. They're coming in losing three of their past four.
Patrick, I'm really interested to see how this Miami team's going to do in the MAC this year. I mean, obviously, that's the most important part of the schedule. MAC, pretty strong conference when it comes to basketball. They have a lot of good teams. Akron, Kent State, Buffalo, Toledo, all expected to have pretty good teams this year. And this Miami team just, it's really a mishmash of so many different people from so many different places. Really hard to know what they're going to do, what this team's identity is going to be once we get into conference play.
That's a good point. And you're not going to know until they start playing games.
Absolutely.
Larry from the far corner kicks it up right wing with a ball. Here is Mabry. He will feed it to the near corner. Lewis there with the three ball. That was short, well short. Jackson State the rebound over the timeline here in the right wing. With the basketball is Evans Jr. to the rack. Fed it back for Cook off the window. Too much. Rebound Red Hawks. Larry over the timeline left wing. Dishes back on the left side outside the arc. Smith three ball. Yes, sir. What a play by Smith to get open and get it in for three. He is 4-for-5 from three-point land tonight.
And Travis Steele talked before this season that Billy Smith is an absolute sharpshooter. He's really showing that now. I mean, 4-for-5 tonight. Didn't know this. He was this good.
Sniper. Far side, Colty Young will go off the window for two with the right arm. Jackson State will make it 58-41 Miami, 14-25 to go second half. Safford top the key to the near wing for Julian Lewis outside the arc. Drives his way through the MAC logo in the paint. Kicks it out near wing outside the arc. Mabry drives, feeds off for Safford with a beautiful play. Moving from the far corner. A baseline drive. He got the feed. Put it off the glass for two with the right arm. 60-41 Miami. 6 minutes into the second half. And a timeout is called by an animated Mo Williams.
Patrick. Travis Steele talked about this week that he wants his team to be hard cuts and find the open man. I mean, that was literally the perfect example of it. Morgan Safford makes that beautiful cut to the basket from the corner. Ryan Mabry finds him with a little no-look bounce pass and perfect, beautiful technical play for the Redhawks. Results in 2 points, and they got a pretty nice lead going here.
Mo Williams just snapped his dry erase board in a
huddle.
He just threw it to the floor, and it broke. And he is just giving it to his guys right now. There's a piece of the board that flew out from the Jackson State bench out onto the floor into the free throw line area.
He just spiked his dry erase marker too.
Oh my gosh.
And number one over there, that's Zeke Cook. he was doing that thing where like when your teacher, your mom's yelling at you and you're kind of trying not to laugh. It looked like he was doing that over there. He's just really, really, really tight.
Oh my gosh, he is fired up tonight.
Yeah, he is. Pretty fun to watch Mo Williams over there on the sideline.
And now he's over there standing where he usually stands for the game, away from the huddle with the I'm not mad, I'm disappointed look on his face. Holy
just,
cow.
Yeah, just hands on the hips, staring into space. He looks like he's wishing that he had stayed at Alabama State.
0-5 this year to start on the Tigers. And if they lose tonight, of course, 0-6. And then guess what? They go to Texas.
Oh, my God.
For a game
serious?
On Saturday at SMU. They're going to spend a few days in the Dallas area. They're going to be at SMU on Saturday. Tuesday, they're going to be at TCU. And then they come back to Ohio to play Akron Sunday, December 11th.
Wow.
What a travel schedule that is.
Wow, that is really awful. And I thought you were saying that they were actually playing against Texas, the number two team in the country right now. So thank goodness for these Jackson State Tigers that they are not actually being sent into the slaughterhouse that is a game against Texas basketball right now.
So they've been in the Midwest already. They were at Michigan Wednesday,
right?
In Ann Arbor. They played at Indiana Friday. They're here tonight. They go to Texas. to play two games, SMU, TCU, then they're back up here and back up in the northern part of the country, I guess you could say, at Akron on December 11th. And then they got a couple road games back down south before they go home. Their home opener is not until December 14th against Mississippi State. And you go home and you play an SEC team.
Yeah, seriously, that is just brutal. I mean, I wonder what the point of that is. Maybe they're, I mean, is their arena getting renovated, or are they really just that hungry for these pay-to-play games?
Desperate to schedule.
Right.
They're at Akron, okay, then they're back home against Mississippi State following that, and then it's back on the road at Texas Tech, at Alabama, at Stephen F. Austin.
Jeez. Texas Tech and Alabama, no slouches.
Nope. So it's flipped in here. Jackson State will draw a foul. It went to the left side of the paint for Romel Manziel, and a foul whistle there. Second foul against the RedHawks, Morgan Safford. Oh, that was who got it. Have to wait for the clarification there. Inbound comes far side of the Jackson State offensive baseline. Cook inbounds it off the foot of the RedHawks, Billy Smith. It was Mabry who got the foul for a second. Safford came up. Marambo's back in for the RedHawks. Far corner goes the inbound here for Jones. Working up the far wing. We had a travel on who? I think on the RedHawks as Lair was trying to carry it up the raveled. And the inbound will come to Jackson State, far side of their offensive baseline with 13:43 to go in the second half. Manziel tosses in top the key with the ball as Evans Jr. with a left-handed dribble. Jackson State top the key. Shovels it far side for Colty Young. Back up top the key with the ball is Evans Jr. dribbling with the right arm with 8 to shoot. Flips it out far wing. 3 try. Colty Young is good for the right wing. And Jackson State finds some offensive life there to make it 60-44, a 16-point game. RedHawks lead with 13:15 left in the second half of the game. Larry near way for Marambo, right side of the paint. Little float pass to the far side. Smith outside the arc. Back left wing for Mabry. Floats it to the far corner. Marambo could not catch the feed, but a whistle came as it went out of bounds off of Jackson State, but a foul came in as well in the play. This is when Marambo was trying to get the feed. He was fouled by Manziel for his second personal, the second team foul against Jackson State in the half. Quick inbound feed. It went from Lewis to Marambo under the hoop. He tipped it out of bounds. They say it went off of Jones, though, of Jackson State. And out the baseline, it's going to stay with the RedHawks. 13:05 to go in the second, 19 to shoot for Miami. Larry will toss it in. Marambo here to the near side of the corner. Marambo trying to make his way toward the paint, and he was fouled with contact coming in from Evans Jr., and also on him was Manziel. And now you got Mo Williams just sitting on the scorer's table at half court, just leaning on it as if he's taking a break from his labor job.
He looks like a teacher who, when the teacher says, "I'm just going to sit here until you guys quiet down," that's exactly what Mo Williams looks like right there, just leaning against that scorer's table.
I'll just wait for you. Here's Marambo driving right side of the post off the window for two with the right arm. The strong reach there. Jones was no match for Marambo. 12:45 to go in the second, 62-44 Miami. Evans Jr. top the key, Young left wing with a three ball is good. Nice open look for Colty Young, who's got the three ball working tonight. He's 4 for 7 from outside the arc. And you know, it's 14 points to lead Jackson State. Top of the key with a basketball, Lewis bounces far side for Marambo. 17 on the shot clock, right wing three, Lewis good, wide open. 65-47 Miami. Over the timeline, middle of the floor is Evans Jr. for Jackson State. Left-handed dribble, feeds left side of the post. Jones to the rack for two, a strong move with both arms off the window for a pair. RedHawks over the timeline here on the left wing. It's Larry. Right-handed dribble, win the ball up top the key. Feeds on the far side with the ball is Lewis. Near wing is Larry, a foul whistled here. As Evans Jr. was in the area, contacted Larry on a right wing drive to the hoop. And with 11:50 to go in the second half, we have immediate timeout from Millett Hall. Miami 65, Jackson State 49. It is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. Miami leaders over Jackson State with 11:50 to go in the second half. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you inside Millett Hall tonight. The inbound will come for the RedHawks into the timeout near wing. And their offensive end of the floor, Morgan Safford, will send this one into Billy Smith, top of the key. And Kyle Leary with it, right side, outside the arc, feeds near corner for Safford. And we'll then get it up top to key for Leary. Right-handed dribble with five to shoot. Leary, it's kind of messed up there by Cook. And we'll pick it up, float a jumper off. It was too hard. Rebound, though, and a foul on Jackson State as Safford went tumbling to the floor. And they're going to get cooked for that. That's another foul on Jackson State, their fifth of the half with 11:30 to go in the second. They're chanting anger management. Larry near wing of the baseline will feed this one near corner for Smith. Back for Marambo, who'll try to back his way toward the hoop. Spins around to the paint, floats it off the glass, and it's good. Marambo, the jumper from 10 feet away in the lane. 67-49 Miami.
300-pound point guard looking more like a ballerina out there on that play.
So graceful. Jones, left side of the paint, floats it far side. Manziel will try to play this one up on the far wing. He could not hit Young in a pass, but he picked it up near half court. Evans Jr. top of the key with a left-handed dribble. Hits the brakes, left side of the paint, and gets it down low with a nice dunk there for Manziel, who's wide open under the hoop. 67-51 Miami, 10:45 to go in the second. Over the timeline left wing, Makai Leary gets to the near side of feed there. The paint, Marambo delayed once, let the man pass, and went off the window for two. Quick feed ahead. Here's Cook for Jackson State under the offensive hoop. Left wing feed for Young, top of the key now is Evans Jr. with a right-handed dribble and 19 to shoot. And a whistle here, it's an offensive violation on the Tigers, gonna go back to the RedHawks. Cook's going to get another foul away from the ball. That's going to be his third. Leading point getter Sapper tonight for the RedHawks was 16. Not far behind are both Mabry and Smith with 14 each. Young, the leading point getter for Jackson State tonight with 14. Manziel follows him with 12.
Patrick, six guys on the RedHawks have over 8 points tonight. Really nice job by them just spreading the ball around and getting offense from wherever they can get it.
Seriously. Safford feeds near wing, outside the arc with it is Mabry. Top of the key, Marombo down low to Larry, right side of the paint, and it will be out of bounds off Jackson State as Cook kind of dove it, trying to steal the ball away from Akai. It tipped off his hand out of bounds on the sideline, and so Larry will inbound here for the near side of his offensive baseline with 14 to shoot. 10:09 to go in the second. In a 69-51 game, Larry bounce pass, left side of the paint with it. Lewis gets it to the lane where Marombo trying to go up for a shot. Young stole it away. And three players actually in the area. Foul is a whistle. They're going to call number 31, Jamarcus Jones, on it for the Tigers. His first, the 17th foul for the Tigers in the half. That puts the RedHawks in the 1-1 bonus. He's going to shoot two, though, as a shooting foul with 10:05 to go in the second. First one, Marombo's good. Almost a 74% free throw shooter on the season, the Cleveland State transfer.
Patrick, he hardly got any minutes last year at Cleveland State. Watching him, it's really kind of mystifying because he was just so talented out there on the floor. Tonight he's taken four shots from the floor, made them all, taken two free throws, and made both of those, too.
And you could argue in a lesser league as well.
Right.
The Horizon League. Top of the key with it is Evans Jr. Drives his way to the lane. Floats it off the window too hard. Rebound offensively for Jackson State. Working hard. Manziel to put back up and under with the right arm for the near side. No good. Rambo the rebound up ahead. Right wing Lewis over the timeline for the RedHawks. Left-handed dribble with 20 to shoot. Top of the key. Larry's got it. Just past the halfway mark of the second half here from Millett. Larry with the ball above his head, feeds up high on the right side for Safford. Left-handed dribble for him, top of the key. Safford around the arc in the near wing, the feed down low, Mabry crossed to the court. Lewis, left wing, coughed it up. Safford floats off a prayer three with one on the shot clock. That was blocked away there by Young, up high, and they're gonna let the bucket count. Colty Young called for basket interference. He leapt up and just swatted it away. And a three will count for Safford with a prayer off balance far side near the Red Hawk bench. 74-51 Miami.
Well, what was he thinking? That ball was nowhere near going in. It was going to be an air ball. And even if it was, that's still going to be a goaltending no matter what.
Going to be a foul on the Red Hawks here as Jackson State was in the offensive end of the floor.
Mo Williams just over there smiling now. He seems to have, I don't know.
It's reached the sarcastic point.
Yeah, right, exactly.
I can relate with my coaching experience.
Yeah, well.
A few points. First free throw good by Young.
Took eight matchups for you to get your first win, right?
Yeah.
Be interesting to see if Mo Williams finds his a little earlier. Getting close.
Top of the key, RedHawks in offense. Smith to the far wing, Safford. Top of the key, Marombo. Safford, right-handed dribble, and he charged over the Jackson State player and Cook, who sold it. And the referee calls the foul on Cook, who just flopped. He's trying to argue his case, but it was a flop. And Safford will go to the line here for free throws. That's the eighth foul as a team for Jackson State. The wheels have just fallen off the bus for the Tigers here in the second half. Marombo's coming out for the RedHawks.
Patrick, looking at their bench right now, everyone on there just looks really disinterested. And every once in a while, they'll go into this defense chant when they're on defense, and it's just the most half-hearted thing I've ever seen those guys on the floor or on the bench try to do it.
Going outside the arc, Manziel drives through the MAC logo, floats it off the rim, too short, rebound picked up by Jones, kicks it back out, Manziel drives down the right side of the paint, he was fouled. Strong contact near the MAC logo, they're going to whistle Julian Lewis on it for the RedHawks, for his third. So the inbound will come first side of the baseline in the Jackson State offensive end from the Tigers. Long stretch pass out for Evans Jr. at the half-court line, who floated a pass to the courtside seats over the head of Colton Young, trying to stay away from a backcourt violation. Redhawks going to get it back here on the turnover with 8.5 to go in the second. Sent in to Lewis over the timeline, middle of the floor for the Redhawks. Feeds to the near wing for Billy Smith. 22 to shoot for the Redhawks. Left side of the elbow is Morris with a ball left side of the paint. Here's Safford waiting, trying to dribble his way in. Safford spin around on Evans Jr. off the window, too strong. Rebound Jackson State. Over the timeline, left wing, Evans Jr. drives his way through the MAC logo and floats it off the window for two. Coast to coast there went Evans Jr. for Jackson State. Mabry's over the timeline, left wing for the Redhawks. Travis Steele going to call a timeout with the Redhawks leading 74-56. It is a 30-second timeout, they say, that turns into a media timeout tonight from Millett Hall. We're back with you in just a moment. Redhawks with the lead. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. .57 to go in the second half of the game. The Redhawks of Miami leading Jackson State 74-56. Back inside Millett Hall, Patrick Guest and Jack Schmelzinger are with you. This point just about closing it out for the Redhawks.
Yeah, and Patrick, it really has kind of felt like the wheels have fallen all the way off the bus for the Jackson State Tigers. They just have not been playing well these last few minutes. And for Miami, it almost is surprising that it's still only an 8-point game. I think if you're the Redhawks, you kind of want to just open this thing up a little bit, try to really make a statement with this win. I think that if they just buckle down and play really well for these next 8 minutes, they have a chance to make this a 25, 30, 35 even point game by the end.
Yep. So the inbound will come for the Redhawks. Far side of their offensive end will be sent in by Safford. Richard Jr. from Columbus, who I found out today is in my Russian foreign policy class.
How'd you only find that out today?
Safford off the window for two with the left arm. Probably my stupidity was the first reason. Evans Jr. over the timeline, middle of the floor. For Jackson State, 76-56 to the corner. Three ball, too hard there from Colty Young. Played up ahead, right wing over the timeline comes Julian Lewis. Left wing Safford for the Redhawks to Lays. Puts it up and one for Morgan Safford. 78-56 Miami, chance for a three-point play with 7:28 to go in the second. And the redshirt junior to the line, an 80% free throw shooter on the season.
And what a game Morgan Safford is having. He came back from injury last game against Arkansas. Little Rock had 9 points. 7 rebounds, 5 assists. That's a really good stat line in today. I mean, he's making that look like nothing. 24 points, only 1 rebound and 2 assists, but really showing off the scoring prowess today is the captain, Morgan Safford.
9 for 14 from the field. Far side, outside the arc is Manziel. Bounce pass right side of the paint. Garami and his Evans Jr. outside the arc with 13 to shoot. Evans Jr. will fire off a triple. It's good. He was on Safford there, was guarding him, and finding some room was Evans Jr. 7 minutes to go here in the second. Over the timeline on the right wing is Larry. Feeds to the near side now for Lewis. Left wing at the elbow. Now with the ball is Marambo for Miami. Hands it off, Safford, left wing outside the arc. Marambo, left side of the paint with a right-handed hook shot, in and out, a little bit too hard. Rebound Evans Jr. for Jackson State. Shovels a right-handed pass, far wing outside the arc, Young. Back up on the far side, Evans Jr. with it for the Tigers. Gets it to the near wing with a basketball. There is Evans Jr. outside the arc with 13 to shoot for Jackson State. Evans Jr. top of the key, behind the back pass. He finds Jones there, near wing Evans Jr. Across the back logo of the paint, right-handed shot was short. Rebound picked up by the RedHawks. Larry feeds up the left wing of the timeline is Billy Smith. Top of the key with it, here's Marambo for the RedHawks. 6:06 to go in the second, 79-59 Miami. Top of the key, Marambo, there for Safford. And he is fouled by Yvonne Johnson. Came in with contact. Johnson fresh in the game, the freshman from Jackson, Mississippi, making his second appearance of the year. And it will have 2 free throws at the line here. The RedHawks are in the double bonus with Jackson State, 10 fouls as a team. 6:01 to go in the second. RedHawks lead by 20. First one, Safford, is good. Into the game is Chase Adams. He started. Evans Jr., another starter, will come out for him. For the Tigers, next free throw good by Safford. RedHawks and Ryan Mabry into the game. Safford's gonna come out. What a night for him, 25 points. He had 9 points against Little Rock, played 36 minutes in that game. Tonight, Safford, 30 minutes, 26 points. Inside the arc in the near wing with a basketball is Jones, feeds Manziel. Top of the key with it is Adams. Around the arc in the left elbow. Adams right-handed dribble, bounce pass left side of the paint for Jones. He will go off the window and in for the and one up high on the glass.
Comes up Miami's Billy Smith.
Billy Smith with some late contact there and the and one play gonna send to the line
for Jackson State. And for the Red
Jackson State. Jones as Marambo's coming out for the RedHawks to an applause from the crowd. He had 10 points on the night, 6 rebounds to lead the team, 7 assists. Jones at the line for a single free throw. 60% shooter on the year, first one is good. 5:39 to go in the second half. Miami 81, Jackson State 82. Inbound comes far wing. Here's Larry with a basketball for the RedHawks. Over the timeline here on the left wing with a right-handed dribble. 5.5 to go in the second. Bounce pass outside the arc in the near wing for Morris. Around the arc. Jaquel Morris top the key for Lewis. 3 ball is off. It is no good, but he was fouled behind the arc. And the fouler, number 31, Jamarcus Jones, held up his arms in innocence for a good 6 seconds after the foul was called.
Yeah, and these Jackson State guys just look really beleaguered right now. I just saw Romel Mansell, who's played almost this entire game. He's been on the floor for 31 minutes of this one. Just went and sat down on the bench, and he looked just frustrated, exhausted, and really ready to go home. Unlucky for him. I don't think he's going to be able to do that really anytime soon, but maybe for a couple days.
Maybe.
I guess their next game isn't until Saturday in Texas.
No. Free throw here is good from RedHawks. Julian Lewis, first of 2. I bet Jackson State drives back after the game tonight, probably about a 9-hour trip. And then they're gonna probably bus to Dallas Friday.
That's a rough schedule. I'm not even looking forward to my 15-minute walk home. Can't even imagine a 9-hour bus drive.
Next one, good by Lewis. And this is his third free throw. That's good. 84-62 Miami, 5:22 to go in the second. Over the timeline, middle of the floor is Chase Adams for Jackson State. Far side outside the arc is Young. Gets it in far side of the paint for Cook. He will spin around, floated off the glass, short. Rebound picked up by Adams, but a foul was whistled, and it's going to go back to the RedHawks. Offensive violation on the Tigers. Thrown in there to McKyler in the inbound. I wonder if the ball just went out of bounds. He never whistled a foul. I believe that's just what happened. On the baseline. Larry picks it up, shovels to the corner. It was Mabry who played it ahead, and then we tipped out of bounds. He's going to stay with the Red Hawks. Off the right hand of Evans Jr. Red Hawks need to send an inbounder in. 4:54 to go in the second. Going to be tossed in here by Lewis. Near corner of the ball is Smith. Left-handed dribble, Billy Smith around the arc. Top of the key for Morris, holds it above his head. Hands it off here for Mabry. Top of the key, far wing now Lewis. Four to shoot for the RedHawks. Lewis, left-handed dribble, left side of the paint. Spins around, pulls up, and it's good for two. Great play by Lewis, staved off the defender, and then sunk it from 7 feet away. Evans Jr. now left wing outside the arc. He'll drop a three. On a good feed to the left wing by Adams. And the score, Miami 86, Jackson State 65. Timeout has been called, I believe, by Travis Steele.
And Jackson State shooting 50% from three in this game. Really a good mark. Just impressive that the RedHawks are still up by 21 points. And Patrick, one thing I'm really impressed with this game, Makai Larry, we see him sometimes. You know, he's usually the primary offensive driver for this team, and sometimes when he's not getting his shots, it seems like he gets just a little behind distributing that ball. Good job by Larry, showing some maturity here,
yes.
The captain, team captain is.
9 points. Who recognizes it's not all about him necessarily. It's about these younger guys. They got to get in. And Larry's the only guy left on this team from a few years ago. I mean, you look at it, so much turnover. Of course, a handful of guys left over from last year on the roster, but when you look at the RedHawks starting five tonight, the only guy that was here last year was Makai Larry, so he understands the big picture here.
Yeah, Patrick, and the only guys who got significant minutes on this RedHawk team last year that are back are Kamari Williams and Makai Larry, and Kamari Williams hasn't played in a few games, so really it is just Makai Larry, even from last year's team almost, on the squad, and he's their main offensive option, and when things get tough, they're going to go Larry's way, but it's nice to see him willing to release the spotlight in a game where other guys are able to shoot well.
4:23 to go in the second. We're in the middle of a media timeout right now. 86-65 Miami on top. As the Red Hawks and Tigers go to battle. Just the second ever meeting between these two teams. December 15th, 2015, these teams saw each other here in Oxford. Miami won that game 64-53. So the Red Hawks with a win tonight could put the all-time series to 2-0 overall. And a Red Hawk team that's enjoying this nice little homestand. Little Rock, they played here on Saturday. They're playing here tonight against Jackson State. Indiana State comes in on Saturday, which should be a good game at 1 o'clock. And then the following Sunday, Calumet College of St. Joseph in Indiana comes in for a 1 o'clock start on December the 11th for Miami. Nice little time for some home games here after you've kind of got the start of the season and that flurry out of the way. Now it's try to find kind of your identity as a team in this stretch in late November, early December, and good time to have home games.
Yeah, it really is. And this week, Travis Steele said that his team so far, since the season started, has really only mostly been able to work on game-by-game preparation just because they've had so many games in such a short period of time. Well, the fact that they're going to be at home so often in the next couple weeks really going to give them the chance to work on some other things, which is obviously going to help such a young, inexperienced Red Hawk team.
All right, so the ball top of the key, Makai Larry with it to the near side for Jaquel Morris. Top of the key, Larry back with the ball with 12 to shoot for the Red Hawks. Left side of the paint, they go to Morris. Far corner with it is Smith. He got stripped, though, by Chase Adams. Went out of bounds on the far sideline near the Red Hawk bench, and Miami's going to keep it with six on the shot clock. Looks like Safford's back in the game, and so is Marombo. 4 minutes to go in the second. Saffron-Lindbaum here trying to fling it over Manziel from his own bench. Got tipped off the hand of Manziel. Adams up ahead for Jackson State. To the rack will go coast to coast and get the and one with a nice left-handed layup. Nice diving play there to get the layup to go in by Chase Adams Jr. from Chicago, and you're going to have him go to the line for a chance at a three-point play.
Adams from Chicago by way of Salt Lake City Community College. It's a pretty interesting path to get to Jackson, Mississippi.
Started in every game, including tonight for the Tigers. Free throw at the line is good there by Adams, who has 8 points tonight. Inbound to the far side here for Larry. Oh, the timeline on the left wing with 3:50 to go in the second. 86-68, Miami with the lead. Top the key with it, Marombo. To the near side outside the arc is Safford. Back up top the key, Mabry with a basketball. Dribbles his way to the top of the key. Marombo's on it for the RedHawks. Trying to dribble his way down the lane and kind of open up. Little floor to the left arm missed. It was short and air ball. Jackson State the rebound over the timeline of the right wing. Evans Jr. to the rack. It's going to be a whistle for an offensive foul as he charged over Larry with 3:27 to go from the right side of the post here in the second half.
Patrick, that's the Travis Steele culture showing through right there. Makai Larry, a team captain, a fifth-year player, the star of this team, getting down and dirty, taking the charge.
I'm laughing because Bo Williams is both the leaning on the scores table and the smile going right now.
Yeah,
he gets better and better.
He does. He's funny over there for sure. I can't tell if he's trying to be, but he is hilarious.
Marombo puts the ball up into the hoop with his right arm on a layup. At the other end, Evans Jr. sinks a jumper there for 10 feet away for Jackson State. Left wing goes in for two. 2:52 to go in the second half, 88-70. The Red Hawk lead here tonight in Oxford. Safford's on the timeline. Left wing will bounce it top of the key for Marombo. Holds on with both arms. Shovels it left side. Larry outside the arc with it for the Red Hawks. Right-handed dribble through the MAC logo. Floats it up with the left arm and good. A strong defense came in there from Evans Jr., but he shut him down. On the timeline, middle of the floor, Evans Jr. there for Jackson State. Left-handed dribble down the left side of the paint and another charge whistle to Safford. Got barreled over there. See what Mo Williams has to say on this one.
And Patrick, Travis Steele does not smile over there on that sideline very often, but that second straight charge in about 2 minutes, Travis Steele, big old smile on his face. That is what that guy loves to see. He just, talking to him, it seems like he just loves the fundamental gritty basketball.
Inbound to Larry here over the timeline on the right wing for the Red Hawks. 2:18 to go in the second. Top the key with it here is Safford. Far side outside the arc, Billy Smith. Back up top the key, Marombo's got the ball for the Red Hawks. Hands it off, Larry, left side of the paint. Marombo jumper off the window, too much. Rebound Evans Jr. over the timeline, right wing, Jackson State. On the left-handed dribble at 23 to shoot, less than 2 minutes to go in the second half. Left wing three is good there from Evans Jr. Jackson State in the field goal shooting working here in these last few minutes of the game.
Yeah, and they've tightened up defensively too. Right. Miami having a lot of more trouble finding space.
Evans Jr. attacked Mabry from behind, going over the timeline on the right wing. There's a foul. Now Mo Williams is pointing and laughing at the referees. He's just asking for it right now.
He is.
He's asking for it. We got word from a source that's right over by their bench that he was asking to go to the locker room earlier on in the game.
Mo Williams was the head coach? You know what? It really does not surprise me at all.
Free throw goes in and out for Mabry.
And a couple minutes ago, one of the Miami sports information directors came over and offered to us, we can go talk to Mo Williams, ask him a few questions after the game if we want. I don't even know what I would want to ask him, but I just want to talk to this guy. Actually, I know what I would ask him, but I don't know, you know, if it would really be appropriate. I would really want to just know exactly what's going through his head this entire game, basically.
1:43 to go. The second free throw is good. 91-73 Miami. Larry's out. Safford's out. Bryce Tatum's in. Eli Yofan is in for the Red Hawks. Right elbow jumper, good by Chase, or missed rather by Chase Adams. Short for Jackson State. Rebound for Rabo, gives it up and over the timeline. Left wing is Billy Smith. Far wing with the ball is Yofan for the Red Hawks. Eli Yofan, the freshman from Pittsburgh. Top of the key, Marambo tries a three, too far left and at the distance. Adams with the rebound over the timeline, right wing for Jackson State. We get a whistle. Nope, never mind. Who's it? Play on, top of the key, Young. Three ball, too far right with it. Rebound played here by Jamarcus Jones. Offensive board, Jackson State, right wing, Young, the three, good.
I kind of forgot about Bryson Tatum. It's his first time out there. He's played in all six games so far this year. I remember in that Marshall game a couple games ago, he was out there at the very end, and Travis Steele was screaming at him, Bryson, if you don't stop talking, I'm going to take you out. He was getting so mad at Bryson Tatum because I guess he wouldn't stop talking. I couldn't tell if it was to the ref or to the other team or both, but seems like maybe a, I don't know if, maybe a little retribution there for Travis Steele.
Yeah. It's a good point. So you got 103 to go. I tell you what, this has been one of the more unique games I think we've ever done.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of storylines coming into the game, and then you just have all the antics going on during it. RedHawks playing really well tonight against an opposing team that's just had a lot of antics tonight. And
has not had an easy road to hoe up to this point.
No, it's been very bizarre.
Yeah, it has. It personally, it's been one of the most fun con basketball games I've watched in person. I mean, even if it was a crappy game, Mo Williams over there on the sideline, just watching, getting to watch him makes it worth it.
You come just see that.
Yeah.
So the Ofan inbounds for the RedHawks from his own baseline. 102 to go in the second half. Miami 91, Jackson State 76. Inbound for Tatum over the timeline. The right wing is Mabry for the RedHawks at the offensive end. He'll be tied up by Johnson. And we get a timeout call by Travis Steele before that happened. Mo Williams going to bring his huddle together. So will Travis Steele with 52.1 to go in the second. So next time this RedHawks team takes the floor is Saturday against Indiana State. And it's a 1 o'clock game. And that'll be a tough test. Obviously a more talented team on paper, Indiana State. Team with some decent basketball pedigree from a pretty good program. So it'll be interesting to see how the RedHawks handle that challenge coming up on this weekend.
Yeah, and Jackson State, watching this game, they don't really seem like a bad team, but they've just had such a rough start to the season. Definitely going to be a different type of test when they play Indiana State this Saturday. I'll be very interested to see how they do against the Sycamores.
Yeah, that's true. Doesn't get any easier for the Tigers. We talked about their SEC slate as you go deep into December, and then it's at SMU, at TCU. Next two games. Playing up ahead for the Red Hawks in the backcourt. Coming out is Tatum. Feeds up top the key with a basketball. Yofan. Outside the arc in the near wing, and a whistle here as it was slapped there by Cook for a foul. Mo Williams going to bring out some new guys off the bench. Fifth personal foul against the Jackson State player Zeke Cook, who maybe just wanted to come out there. Sophomore from Starkville, Mississippi. Now the Red Hawks going to bring out some more bench players. Jackson Kenyon is going to come in. You're going to have, looks like, Will Stevens return. Referee's telling him to come in. They're pretty rusty on the check-in procedure.
Yeah, Jackson Kenyon looks like he forgot how to check in. I don't blame him. I'm not sure if he's actually appeared in a game so far this year. Definitely not one that I've watched.
He's appeared one time against Goshen on November 12th. He played 3 minutes. First one, Yofan is good. 44.1 to go in the second, 92-76 Miami. Next one's good from Tatum. So here comes over the timeline, Jackson State. Adams from the near side of the paint will float it off the rim, too short. Jones there to clean up the rebound, though, with the offensive board off the window for two with the right arm. RedHawks at 27 on the shot clock, 30 seconds to go in the second half. Tatum feeds up ahead, near wing outside the arc with Stevens. Got it down low, a play there by Riley at the hoop. He was fouled, trying to go up for the right-handed shot at the post. Or was that an offensive foul?
In all seriousness, thanks for 2016.
Really confused me. They counted the basket. Two, it could have been goaltending. I think that might be what it was. 95, yeah, it was. 95-78 Miami. Three ball first side of the arc. It was too strong there. That came off the hands of the Jackson State player and Jones. Red Hawks over the timeline. The shot clock is off. 10 seconds to go. Tatum stands in the big red M here at half court with a left-handed dribble. And will dribble this one out. The Miami Red Hawks will get the win tonight. 95-78 over the Jackson State Tigers. The Red Hawks have won two in a row. They're now 3-4 overall. They start the homestand off 2-0. And Miami put it together and all together. Great performance tonight. Jackson State starts winless in their first six games of the season, 0-6 overall. They will go to SMU on Saturday, but for the Red Hawks, what a great performance tonight. Threw together some good offense, some good defense. Everything else pretty much was clicking. And a Miami team that's got a lot of confidence going into the back half of this homestand.
Absolutely, Patrick. Like you said, just everything really felt like it was clicking for the Red Hawks today, especially the shots. 60% from the floor, 50% from three, 88% from the line. When you have shooting numbers like that, you're going to win a lot of games. And it really just felt like Miami came to play here today. It's a great win, like you said, a good one for them to build off, especially because they played so well in the underlying aspects of the game. And for me, I'm just glad that I'm not driving 9 hours back to Jackson, Mississippi tonight, and I bet the Redhawks feel the same way.
Yeah, I would agree. Leading point getter tonight was Safford for the Redhawks with 26, and we kind of talked about it a little bit. Just seems like this Redhawks team, it's about being more about a team type of game, a team type of dynamic. Lots of different contributors here tonight for the Redhawks. So good to see early on in the season with a new head coach and so many new faces on this team.
Yeah, it really is, and it's a seems like a really promising sign that all of these guys were able to shoot so consistently tonight. We saw in the game against Marshall, really, the Redhawks struggled a lot shooting, and today they really turned that around, so you need to see a few more consistent efforts like this before you can really call them a good shooting team, but that is what Travis Steele called them coming into this year. They certainly look like it tonight.
They did for sure. 95-78, your final for Jack Schmelzinger, Patrick Geshan, saying so long, good night from Millett Hall. Natalie Valvo will take you the rest of the way with a post-game show. Natalie?
I like to call this game Mo Williams, Mo Problem for this Jackson State team. The Redhawks blew them out 95-78 with a work of art that took place on the court today. You had freshman Billy Smith with 14 points, going 5-for-6 from the field goal and 4-for-5 from the three-point line. Oh my gosh, that for a freshman to be shooting like that, that is spectacular. This kid is tall and lanky, but he knows how to use his body. I feel like, you know, the best way to compare him to is almost like to Kevin Durant type. He's deceiving in his looks, but he knows how to use his body, and he's a lot stronger than what is given off. I know there was a lot of Mo Williams jokes made today. And they were rightfully so, though. He broke his clipboard at halftime, actually shattering it all over the court. Things just weren't connecting for Jackson State today. Having their highest points be 20 points by Colty Young, as we had our highest score be Morgan Safford with 26 points. Just all around, the Redhawks were to connect more on the offensive and defensive boards. They had less turnovers this game. Just things were falling into place for them. And I like how Coach Steele and his assistant coaching staff approached it, because there were times even with this lead that they would get upset. But it was like rightfully so upset, you know, it's when kind of the Redhawks would start to get lazy on certain things, you know, kind of get a little sleepy, and coaches got mad, and then those players put it right back together. You know, it's easy at, you know, especially in half basketball, for it to be like 8 minutes left in the half and to get sloppy with it and to be up by 20 points, and it's easy to lose that. I mean, 8 points is a lot of time. Eight minutes is a lot of time in basketball to come back and for things to get changed up. But, you know, those Redhawks came out, like I said, with some pep in their step, and they just beat Jackson State to every punch. You know, and what shocked me too, around like 5 minutes, 4 minutes, Jackson State started tightening up on defense a little too late, in my opinion. I think it's a little ridiculous. You see this in pros, you see this in AAU, in high school, and kind of everywhere. For some reason, when teams are down by a significant amount, they decide to, like, hey, let's play a full court press. Why don't you start that full court press in the first minute of the first half? If you're going to do that, you got to start right away, because then you're playing catch-up. That's actually probably one of my biggest pet peeves when it comes to basketball. I could talk about that all day. Don't full court. What's the point of full court pressing if you are down by 20 points with 3 minutes left and a half? I mean, you're just going to wear your players out. I know I have said that, like, a lot can change that time, but I don't think a full court press is going to change it around. If it was a 10-point, 5-point game, yeah, full court press with 3 minutes. But other than that, you want to kind of maybe do a half court press or just a good defense, maybe even a zone, and you want to get that ball moving. I mean, Miami's got a great setup here. They're going to be frightening for years to come, especially if – Anderson Mobo, I said his last name wrong, my bad. Marimbo sticks around for a fifth year, because he's kind of like the plug down there. And the key is they've got these other guys out there shooting the three. So while these other teams like Jackson State want to stop the three ball, then you got the big man inside who can also play outside the key. So it's difficult on what's going to work here, especially too next year with the recruiting class, how Coach Deal's going to work around all that, what type of future he sees with this. It'd be a great question to ask him. I'd love to do that. So, Coach Steele, if you're listening, let's sit down and chat, because I've got some questions on where you see the team going, because, man, they've got a bright future. You've got to be happy so far with your first few games as head coach. But again, like, that's really just what helped the RedHawks, is that they can drive it into the basket, but they can also play outside. And that's what wore out this Jackson State team. They didn't know how to do it. Also, Coach Steele did an amazing job with his substitutions. He's got a long bench, and a lot of those guys were going in and out, going in and out. The minute Jackson State thought they knew the game Miami was playing, Coach Steele would throw in some new couple guys and it would change the dynamic just a little bit. But these players, they've obviously practiced that. They obviously have a good brotherhood, because sometimes that can, you know, throw off a team a little bit. But these guys, when a player came in, instantly they were able to connect. They were able to pick up, keep the ball rolling. No pun intended there. So all around, it was just a great game for Miami. They'll be playing here. Let me pull this up when their next game will be. They will be playing against Indiana State this Saturday at 1 p.m. You can watch it on ESPN3 or listen right here to Red Hawk Radio. That's going to be a good game as well, and it'll be interesting to see, you know, what momentum they take from this game going into that, what they've learned from losing to a good team like Indiana University. You know, it's those kind of losses that are going to prepare them for the MAC, for the season games, MAC season games, for if they make it to the tournament, for all that kind of stuff. You know, losses against teams like that are only going to build them up, and I think we already saw that right here today. So it was a great game to watch. Excited to be calling alongside here with Red Hawk Radio. It's been my pleasure today, and I just want to say good luck. Men's basketball, we're all rooting for you. And stay tuned, because Miami football is heading down to the Bahamas as they've got a seed in the Bahama Bowl. That game is December 16th. Stay tuned for that. The guys are going to freaking blow it away. Live from Millett Hall, it's Natalie Valvo, 9:07 p.m. This is Red Hawk Radio, WMSR. Thanks for listening. We'll see you next time.